إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله تعالى فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إقراراً بربوبيته وإرغاماً لمن جحد وكفر كل من عليها فان ويبقى وجه ربك ذو الجلال والإكرام. يقول ربكم سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Allah the Exalted, He mentions in His glorious book, O you who believe, fear Allah the fear that He deserves, and do not die except in the state of Islam, which is submission to Allah Azza wa Jal. We begin by praising Allah Azza wa Jal, and we send our peace and blessings upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear respected brothers in Islam, Anas ibn Malik, he narrates a story that occurred with his uncle, Anas ibn al-Madar. The battle of Badr came, the first battle in Islam. And Anas ibn al-Madar, he missed this battle. And he was very upset, extremely upset. So much so that he says, he came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he says to him, O Prophet of Allah, Ya Rasul Allah, غبت عن أول قتال قاتلت المشركين. He says, O Prophet of Allah, I missed the first battle that you battled the disbelievers. And then he says to him, لئن أشهدني الله مع النبي قتال المشركين لا يرين ما أصنع. Then he makes an oath, and he says, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has allowed me to witness another battle with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then he will see exactly what I will do. He made an oath. Here, Anas ibn al-Nadar, a companion of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, makes an oath, and he stays true to his oath. My brothers in Islam, come time for the battle of Uhud, Anas ibn al-Nadar, we all know what happens in the time of battle of Uhud, when the Muslims clashed with the disbelievers, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he positioned a number of archers up on the surrounding mountain, and he positioned them over there and he told them, do not move, whatever happens, if we're winning, if we're losing, you stay up there. And then the Muslims, they progressed with this battle and they started to defeat the disbelievers, and the Muslims who were positioned on this mountain, they saw the believers winning, so they ran down and they disobeyed the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. At that time, Khalid ibn al-Walid was on the disbelieving side, standing with his cavalry and all of his men, watching those believers who were walking down that mountain, leaving a gap, a strategic wall, a strategic gap in that wall. So he ran around the mountain with his cavalry and he sandwiched the Muslims from the back. And now instead of the believers marching forward, they began to lose, everyone was getting frantic. The disbelievers were now moving forward, they were not running away, and the believers were getting sandwiched by the kuffar. My brothers in Islam, at this point in time, when the companions were getting, some of them had their morale dropped so much they left their weapons on the ground. They said, I'm not going to fight anymore. Why? Because there was a rumor that circulated around Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam had died. There was a rumor that circulated around that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam had died. My brothers in Islam, some of the companions ran. They turned and they ran away from this battlefield. The believers at this time were tested so much so down to the core. And Anas ibn al-Nadar, my brothers in Islam, it was narrated that he was running into the battlefield. And one of the other companions, he says, where are you going? He says to him, I'm running into the battlefield. He says to him, have you not heard that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has died? Then he says to him, what's the point of living after the death of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? And he ran into this battlefield and he fought ferociously. He fought like a brave man, so much so that the narration says there was 80 odd wounds on his body when they found him when he was dead on the battlefield. 80 odd wounds from a slash from a sword or a spear that had entered his body or an arrow that entered parts of his body. So much so that no one was able to identify who this body was, because the disbelievers also mutilated him. Except his sister, she found a birthmark on his body that she was able to identify for him to be her brother. My brothers in Islam, Anas ibn al-Nadhr here, he made an oath that when the next time comes where we are going to meet the disbelievers, you will see exactly what I do. And he fulfilled his oath like a true man. My brothers in Islam, the companions, radiallahu ta'ala anhum, they say that a verse came down, and every time we read this verse, we always say that this verse was sent because of Anas ibn al-Nadhr, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ رِجَالٌ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ رِجَالٌ صَدَقُوا مَا عَاهَدُوا اللَّهَ من المؤمنين رجال صدقوا ما عاهدوا الله عليه. That from amongst the believers are men, my brothers in Islam, that they hold true to what they made an oath for. This is the type of men Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was surrounded by. My brothers in Islam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in an authentic hadith, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِيُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. Verily I was sent to complete and perfect the noble manners. My brothers in Islam, for you to attain noble manners, you need to have a quality. This quality is called al-wafa, fidelity. What is fidelity, my brother in Islam? It's to be loyal. It's to hold true to what you make an oath for. And every single one of us, we all make an oath. But my brother in Islam, you hold true and you stay loyal to the haq, to only what is true. So if you made an oath to something and then you found out that the oath that you made was incorrect or it was not upholding the truth, then for you, my brother in Islam, you are to change this oath. As Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in a hadith, من حلف على يمين فرأى غيرها خيرا منها فليكفر عن يمينه وليفعل الذي هو خير. Here Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in his hadith that whoever made an oath and then he sees something better than the oath that he has made on, then for him he is to expiate for his previous oath and go and make an oath so he can uphold the truth, my brother in Islam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the scholars, my brothers in Islam, they speak about a good type of fidelity. This type of fidelity humbles you and I. It humbles you and I through our deeds. So we stay loyal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What's this type of fidelity? What's this type of loyalty to Allah azza wa jal? You continuously remind yourself of the previous condition that you were in. So one of us that's sitting right here today could have been in a position in his life where he had poor health. And now Allah Azza wa Jal has given him health. And he is healthy. He is fit. He is strong. Or one of us here may have been in a position in our life previously where we didn't have money. We were short for money. And then now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted you wealth. He has granted you possessions. He's given you money. My brothers in Islam, this is a good type of fidelity. That you remind yourself that on a daily basis, so you can stay loyal to Allah Azza wa Jal. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he speaks about a group of people in the Quran. They make an oath. And when the time comes, they turn away. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says? وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ عَاهَدَ اللَّهَ لَإِنْ آتَانَا مِنْ فَضْلِهِ لَنَصَّدَّقَنَّ وَلَنَكُونَنَّ Here Allah Azza wa Jalla says there is a group of people. They will make an oath. They will say that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives me money, then I'm going to go and give for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla. I'm going to donate for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jalla. I'm going to be from those who bring about goodness. And then what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say about them? فَلَمَّا آتَاهُمْ مِّن فَضْلِهِ بَخِلُوا بِهِ وَتَوَلَّوا وَهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted this person from his endless bounties. And then when he received this money and this possession and this wealth, he turned away and he denied any oath that he had already made. Not showing fidelity, not showing loyalty to Allah Azza wa Jal, not upholding the truth, not upholding his oath that he had made to Allah Azza wa Jal. And this reminds us of the story of the people of Bani Israel, the leper, the blind, and the bald men. All three of them had issues with their health. The first one had issues with his skin. And then the angel came down, Angel Jibreel, and he says to him, "What is most beloved to you?" He says to the angel, "Good skin. I want to have good skin." And so he wipes over his skin and he gets good skin, no longer has leprosy. And then he says to him, "Which of the wealth is most beloved to you?" He says to him, "The most beloved to me is camels." And so he is granted a value worth of camels. The angel went to the second man who was bald. And he says to him, "What's the most thing that's beloved to you?" He says to him, "Hair. I want to have hair on my head." So he wipes over his head and he starts to get hair all over again. And now what happens? He says to him, "What is the most beloved of wealth to you?" He says to him, "Cows." So he's granted a value worth of cows. And then he went to the third man who was blind. And he says to him, "What's the most beloved to you?" He says to him, "Eyesight." He wipes over his eyes and now he's able to see again. And then he says to him, "What's the most beloved to you in wealth?" He says to him, "Sheep." And so he's granted a value worth of sheep. Time goes by. The angel comes in a form of a man who is traveling, very old, very weak, very sick. And he goes to the first man who had leprosy. And he says to him, "I ask you by Allah Azza wa Jal to help me as I'm traveling and I need some money. And you can see me, I'm a sick old person." He says to him, "Times are tough, I don't have any money." The angel turns around and says to him, "Weren't you that man who had leprosy and he had a skin condition, and then Allah Azza wa Jal cured you?" He denied it. And he says, "No, I wasn't that person. That wasn't me." And so the angel says to him, If you are lying, then I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to destroy you." He goes on to the second person who was bold. Same thing occurs. He goes to the third person who was blind and he says to him, "I'm an old weak man, I need some money." And he says to him, the blind man who was blind, he says to him, "By Allah Azza wa Jal, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has cured my eyesight. It is Allah Azza wa Jal who has granted all of my wealth here. You can see a value worth of sheep. You can take all of it for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal." And he began to prepare himself so he can give this wealth to this man. Yet this man says to him, Hold on. Keep your wealth with you. Verily you are being tested and you have passed the test, and your brothers that have failed the test and Allah Azza wa Jal has destroyed them. My brothers in Islam, show fidelity. Show fidelity. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted you something, be loyal to Allah Azza wa Jal. Thank Him. For verily all of us go through conditions and phases in our lives where we're not the best. And then later on, we find ourselves healthy, wealthy, in a great position. Be of those who are loyal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers in Islam, a type of fidelity that every single one of us must adhere to is when you make an oath to take some money from someone, and you made an oath to this person that you will return this money. You're going to borrow this money from someone. You're a man of your word. You gave him that word. You give him the money. If you said exactly after one month, what do you do, my brother in Islam? You go and give him that money. You don't make him run after you week after week, chasing you for that money. Be a man of your word. You ask for some money, you give it back as soon as you have fulfilled that time frame that you've agreed on. My brothers in Islam, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says in an authentic hadith, من أخذ أموال الناس يريد أداءها أدى الله عنه. In this hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, whoever takes the money of people, meaning he's going to borrow this money, if he borrows this money and he has the intention of paying it back, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it easy for him so he can pay it back. He will give him the right, he will open up the correct situations for him to make money so he can pay it back to this person. Yet, the second part of this hadith, my brothers in Islam, which is the more important part, which is the most dangerous part, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, وَمَنْ أَخَذَهَا يُرِيدُ إِتْلَافَهَا أَتْلَفَهُ اللَّهُ. That whoever takes this money, and his intention is to what? Is to ruin this money. So he's going to take it, spend it, and run away. He's not going to give it back. Or let this person run after me week after week, and then I'm going to give back the money, whatever it is. His intention was to ruin it. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, Allah azza wa jal will ruin this person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from above the seven heavens will ruin this person. My brothers in Islam, just to show you the importance of debt and paying it off and being a man to your word, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says about the shaheed, about the man who dies on the battlefield. A man who dies on the battlefield. We know the status of the man who dies in the battlefield. He says, all of his sins will be forgiven. Except what? Except the debt that he owes. All of his sins will be forgiven. The one who dies on the battlefield. Except what, Ya Rasulullah? The debt that he owes. That he owes people. My brothers in Islam, to be of those who attain the noble manners in our lives, we must show fidelity. We must show loyalty. We must be true to our words. I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to make us from those who practice fidelity in our lives. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على دربه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. My dear respected brothers in Islam, I remind myself to fear no one except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and do not die except in the state of Islam, which is submission to Allah Azza wa Jal. My brothers in Islam, to show loyalty, to show fidelity, to be a true man of your word when you make an oath, and to uphold your pledge that you've made to whatever situation that you've made, you must have two fundamentals in your life. If these two fundamentals are non-existent, then you are not able to fulfill this pledge. How do we know this? The story of our father, Adam alayhi salam. Adam alayhi salam took an oath and a pledge that he will never go near what? The tree. And he will not eat from his tree. Yet Adam alayhi salam, he ate from that tree. And Allah Azza wa Jalla makes mention of this in the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the reason why Adam alayhi salam was not able to fulfill his pledge. My brothers in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ عَهِدْنَا إِلَىٰ آدَمَ مِنْ قَبْلُ فَنَسِيَ وَلَمْ نَجِدْ لَهُ عَزْمًا. Here Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, we have taken a pledge from Adam. We have taken an oath from Adam alayhi salam. That he will not go near what? The tree. But there were two things that occurred. That was his downfall. فَنَسِيَ وَلَمْ نَجِدْ لَهُ عَزْمًا. The first thing is, he forgot. And the second thing was, he didn't show determination. My brothers in Islam, You need to constantly remind yourself of the oath that you have made. So go back 5 years, if you're sitting in one of those fundraising dinners and you put your hand up and you said, I make a pledge to give $10,000. Yet you didn't remind yourself, and up until today, you still haven't paid off this pledge. Why? Because you completely forgot. Our daily transactions and our daily occurrences make us forget. But remind yourself constantly, I made a pledge. I made a pledge. I need to pay off this pledge. I made an oath. I'm going to fulfill this oath. I'm going to be a man of my word. And constantly remind myself on a daily basis so I don't forget. That's the first one. Second one is, I need to show determination. What does show determination mean here? My brother in Islam, showing determination to fulfill your oath, your pledge, is to work and make sure that you're doing everything that is possible so you can achieve this goal. So what's your strategy? If I made a pledge to give $10,000 and I've got $1,000 in my pocket, what's my strategy? Every single week I'm going to give $200, for example. That's my strategy. I'm working towards it. If I don't show any determination, if I don't show any way possible where I can fulfill this pledge, let's just say I took some money from someone and I borrowed this money and I said I'll give it back to him in 4 weeks' time. If I'm not working in these 4 weeks' time to show determination to give it back, my brother, you're sinning. You're not fulfilling your oath. You took an oath, fulfill your oath. So first thing is, always remind yourself. And the second thing is, show determination. Work towards it. Strive to be a man of your word. Just like Anas ibn al-Nadr, he was a man of his word when he ran into the battlefield, in the battle of Uhud. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who practice fidelity, who are loyal, and who uphold our oaths. I ask Allah azza wa jal to protect us, to protect our families in these challenging times. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who enter the paradise and who work and strive for the actions of the paradise. I ask Allah azza wa jal to protect us from the hellfire and from all the actions that get us near the hellfire. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us and to guide people through us and to make us a reason for other people to be guided. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت وسلمت وباركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت وبارك اللهم لنا فيما أعطيت وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت فإنك تقضي بالحق ولا يقضى عليك اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداء الدين اللهم أيد كلمة الحق والدين اللهم من أراد للمسلمين خيرا فوفقه لكل خير ومن أراد للمسلمين غير ذلك فخذه أخذ عزيز مقتدر يا جبار يا منتقم اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله